Now from the windy city of Chicago, baseball from beautiful Wrigley Field. A good one on tap for you this afternoon between the Chicago White Sox and the Chicago Cubs. It's Interleague Baseball next on the show. John Lester is on the mound for the Cubs in this one. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Matt, this guy has a great mix of fastballs. He has a four-seamer that's straight that he'll ride up in the zone, and then he has the cutter, which breaks away. Two pitches that look the same, that have different angles and different breaks, and if he has a good cutter this afternoon, that makes his four-seam fastball up in the zone that much better.
So striding forward now, Brandon Guyer, and we are ready for some daytime baseball. Fastball taken a little under the letters, called a strike. Here comes the 0-1. Breaking ball below the zone. That's ball one. Very nice afternoon, high skies and 77 degrees at game time. The 1-1 home. Now a swing and he pops him up. This is right out in front of the mound. Lester will do this himself, and that's the first out. Now a moment here to check out the White Sox starting lineup. Who's the one to watch, Dan?
Well, Matt, the guy to watch has to be Jose Abreu. Last year, he won the American League Silver Slugger for first baseman. You think about that. Everybody who plays first can hit, and he hit above the top of the heap. He's a pretty special hitter.
Next to bat will be the Cuban import, Yoan Moncada.
Come on now, let's go.
Now the first pitch here from Lester. Fouled off. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Started the breaking ball far too inside that time, laid off for ball one. So let's take a peek at our umpiring crew in this one. Behind the plate is Clyde Washington.
You know, D-Row, he is a pitcher's best friend, Clyde Washington. Down in the strike zone, he'll definitely call that ball right at the knees.
If he's consistent with it, Dan, which Clyde always is, I'm okay with it.
Bases are empty, one man out. And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down.
Boy, there's nothing better from a pitcher standpoint than watching that high fastball, a high piece of cheese swung at and missed. That pitch looks so inviting to hit, but it's awfully tough to put in play.
So here's the slugging first baseman, Jose Abreu now. And he puts it on the ground to second. Throw on to first gets him, and the side is retired. A solid start to this one for John Lester. It's the White Sox nothing. Cubbies coming to bat. A windy city showdown, and it's on the show. Carlos Rodon is ready to go as he'll be on the mound for the Southsiders. What do we need to know here, Denny?
Hey, thanks, Matt. Carlos Rodon, the pride and joy of NC State University. Overpowering fastball at times, 94 to 96 miles an hour with some cutting action. His best secondary pitch is the hard slider and does have a changeup that's on the improve. If he brings all three of these, he has a chance to shut anybody down.
Slider laid off for a ball. The 1-0. High and deep to right center. Engel giving chase. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. And a chance now from the north side of Chicago to check out the Cubs starting lineup. How do they go about taking down their division rival, Mark DeRosa?
Maddie, this is going to be a fun lineup for me to watch. I get fired up watching these guys because they all have a plan. It works for them. They follow the scouting reports. They grind it out in a video room. I'm interested to see what they've come up with.
Here's Chris Bryant now. Previously against Carlos Rodon, he's 0 for 5. First pitch of the at bat. Well struck, but foul over by the coaching box. Outside for a ball, one and one. One out, nobody on. One ball and two strikes to count. The 1-2. He is swung on and missed. He got him on strikes.
I like how he worked him backwards for that strikeout there. He wasn't showing the fastball early in the at-bat, but then went back-to-back once he had the hitter down in the count.
The next Cub up, Anthony Rizzo. First cuts for him here with the bases open and two away. Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. Off the plate and away there. One ball, no strikes. Two out, nobody on. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Engel on the move. Running hard. He's digging for second. And he'll make it to second base now with two gone.
As we take a look at the replay here, you can see that it was a hanging changeup. Nice job of staying back on it, and he's able to tattoo it for a double. And you know, if that pitch would have supplied more velocity, it might have been out of here. He hit it right on the screws.
Here's Javier Baez, as the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one.
These are the moments you can't relax. You never know when you're going to be able to score a few runs off a great pitcher. Here's the spot right here early. Have to find a way. You're happy with one, but if someone can catch a gap, this game could get out of hand pretty quick.
Shoots this one over to first. Taken in by Abreu, and nothing will come of the two-out double as the inning is over. Danger averted following the two-out double. We're off to the second, scoreless on the show. Here's the catcher, Wellington Castillo. His past history against John Lester, batting at an even 400. Now the pitch. And this one's not close. It's in the dirt for ball one. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Skied into straightaway right. Hayward has a read on it. He's got it one away.
Okay, here's how the Cubbies are lining up defensively. And this team, they're not going to be moving around as much as some of the new age teams. The shifting and moving the third baseman over second base and the right fielder to play third base. This is going to be your stationary team, trusting pitchers to execute pitches.
Up next for Chicago, Leury Garcia, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Now the first pitch here from Lester. Changeup called strike one.
There's a called strike on a changeup, not a particularly good one. That changeup up in the zone like this oftentimes gets hit very hard. Was able to get away with it that time, but if he's going to be successful, he's going to need to get that changeup down in the zone around the knees.
No score here as we play inning number two. He ties him up with a fastball inside, one and two. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Well, that call looked like it was a little in the pitcher's favor, but it wasn't outrageous. Hey, listen, calling balls and strikes is a really tough job, and even the best are going to miss some from time to time, especially when they're sort of borderline like that last one. Not sure the hitter would want to hear that, though.
And that'll bring up the shortstop, Tim Anderson, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one.
Well, even though these two teams are in different leagues, they do play each other every year because of the crosstown rivalry, and it's always pretty fun.
Yeah, and for the players, Matt, they love it. Not only is there more on the line than usual, like bragging rights, but they're not having to stay at hotels and all that. It's just like a normal home game where they're driving to a different ballpark.
And the cutter got him swinging. Strike three, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the White Sox. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. So in now for Chicago, Kyle Schwarber, previously against Carlos Rodon. He's a perfect 2-for-2. He also has one home run. First pitch on its way. And he gets ahead here with the fastball, strike one. Schwarber, playing here in his age 26 season. He was selected in the first round during the 2014 draft.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an absolute superstar. Everybody knows this guy's name, and kids are buying his jerseys.
Now the 0-2 pitch. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first out.
Okay, guys, here's how the Southsiders are lining up on D today. And, guys, what I want you to focus on today is this is one of the new age teams in the game that really rely on statistics and the numbers. And the numbers tell them that they're a better team defensively, moving guys around and shifting as much as they can.
Here's the young catcher, Wilson Contreras. Here's the first pitch to him. This is lined to left, but pretty much right at the left fielder as he takes it in for the second out. Here's Jason Hayward now. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And a fastball close, but ultimately ruled a ball. 1-0. Swung on, but fouled off to the left. The 1-1. Lofted in the air out toward right center. Guyer has a read on it. Makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. Cubs are down in order. We'll move to the third with no score.
Digging in, the switch hitter, Yoelmer Sanchez. He's the number seven hitter, but he's leading off the third after the first six guys in the lineup have been retired in order.
Yeah, it's been a great start to the guy on the mound. It'll be interesting to see if they can find a way to get to this guy before he really settles in.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Little tardy on that swing as it's well wide of first. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Oh, and you talk about a pitcher getting the benefit of the doubt. That's low, but called a strike anyway. Nothing in two now. Popped up, and he'll put this one away for the first out of the inning. One out here in the Shy Sox third, and up next, one of the best defensive center fielders in the league, Adam Engel. First pitch coming, here it is. Pitch taken several inches below the zone, in fact. Now the 1-0. Fly ball out toward left center field. Waiting on it is Almora. Makes the play, and there are two gone now. Ready now for the White Sox, Carlos Rodon. Lester gets the sign. First pitch on its way. And a fastball's in there for strike one. The White Sox are still looking to break into the hit column here. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Into the windup with the 0-2. Pulled toward right center field. Almora in pursuit. And this is hauled in on the run as he takes quite a tumble but hangs on, and the inning is over. Another look at the acrobatic play out there in center. Back for more from the north side after this. And now here's the versatile outfielder, Albert Almora Jr. Previously against Carlos Rodon, he's 1-for-4. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Good changeup, and it's 0-2.
I guess he's really trying to measure that fastball in his first at bat, but you really never want to put yourself in 0-2 count if you could do anything about it.
Tries the slider to ring him up, but he lays off 1-2.
I know he buried that slider in right there, but that's a dangerous pitch. If he doesn't pop commit and bury that inside, it leaks out over the plate. He can get hurt with that pitch.
This is line to left. He dives. Did he catch that? He did. What a play there for the first out.
Taking another look at it, the ball has some top spin on it, but he's on the full run and dives to make the catch. Nice defensive play right there.
David Bote is into the on-deck circle now as he'll pinch hit for the pitcher, Lester. Lays off 1-0. Bottom of inning number three, nothing, nothing our score. And oh, looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1.
Plain to see right there that the manager's sticking up for his hitter, making sure that that strike zone gets a little bit tighter. It's tough to cover both sides of the plate, and they both want that strike zone to be shrinked up a little bit.
1-2 now as that one's fouled off. Ooh, he saws him off with that one. And he'll flip it to the pitcher covering for the out. At the plate, Ben Zobrist. He flew out in his last at-bat. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Swing and a ball lifted in the air toward the line and right. In there, a base hit.
Yeah, maybe a shot here now with two as they finally get another base runner on. He stranded six in a row prior to this point, so he's had his way with these guys for the past couple of innings.
Stepping into the box, Chris Bryant. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You could tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AD.
First pitch on its way. A ball and no strikes. The set and the 1-0. That one's going to find the seats. Strike one. The set and the 1-1. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. Bryant looking at a 3-1 count.
Well, this has been a long inning already, and I know he doesn't want it to get any longer. I expect a challenge pitch right here.
Zobrist leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that nearly broke our scoreless tie. Instead, it's a foul ball.
All right, 3-2 count with two outs. The runner on first will be moving, so we'll see what happens. There are a lot of possible outcomes with this kind of play.
And that'll get down out there for extra bases. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
No mistake what he was sitting on. Fastball, middle of the plate, kept his hands back, stayed through the baseball, and delivers a hard hit line drive.
Anthony Rizzo stands in now as he takes a called strike on the black. It's 0-1. It was a double for him in his first turn at the plate. Ready with the 0-1. And he fouls this one off. Here comes the 0-2. And another foul ball. Second and third, two away. A ball and two strikes to Anthony Rizzo. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Cubs strand a couple. We'll head to the fourth, still scoreless. Tyler Chatwood, a right-hander standing 6 foot even, will take over the pitching duties here. Digging in for his second at-bat, Brandon Guyer. He popped out in his first trip.
Yeah, I don't mind him trying to drive the ball in the air, but he can't collapse the backside, and that's exactly what he did in his last at-bat. Look for him to stay a little taller and keep that upper half a little bit more over him.
The windup and the 1-0 pitch. Lays off a fastball that doesn't miss by much, and it's 2-0. Two and one count to the Pale Hose leadoff hitter. The 2-1 home. Swing here on the fastball, and this will get fouled off to the right side. Oh, but he robs him on a super diving catch. So the bases are empty with one man gone, and that'll bring up the former top prospect as a minor leaguer, Yoan Moncada. Here comes the first pitch. Right there for strike one. Moncada, 23 years old. He's in his third season as a major league player. Hard hit ball to second. There to play to Zobrist, and that's the second out. So coming to the plate, Jose Abreu. He's 0 for 1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First pitch coming, here it is. And a fastball to start things out here. Not close. It's a ball and no strikes.
Right there is a temptation pitch. Power hitters like this are looking for pitches that they can drive. So that may have been one where he was trying to get him to chase up above the zone a little bit.
And oh, looked like ball two below the knees, but it's ruled a strike, and that evens the count at 1-1. 2-1 the count to the White Sox first baseman. From the windup, the 2-1 pitch. Changeup, called a strike, and he comes back even at 2-2. Two balls, two strikes, a crucial count for both pitcher and hitter. So, Dan, what was your approach on the mound in that count? Do you still pitch for the strikeout here?
I think one of the keys, Matt, you want to try to initiate contact. The one thing you don't want to do, you don't want to run the count to three balls and two strikes. Whatever you want to throw, throw it over for a strike.
Here's the payoff pitch. In the dirt, but swung on and missed. And the throw to first ends the inning. Down in order go the White Sox. On to the bottom of the fourth now, still with no score. Now the Cubs four-hole hitter, Javier Baez, 0-for-1 for him here in this one. First offering on its way. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Down the left field line and deep, and that will end up a foul ball. Into the windup, here comes the 0-2 pitch. And a fastball in the dirt that's taken for a ball. And time, this is swung on and missed, and this fourth inning will start the same way he ended the third, with a strikeout, and there's one away. Good job of making him chase a pitch for the strikeout there.
Yeah, Matt, that's the advantage of getting ahead in the count. You can really force hitters to expand their zone and protect. And when they're in that mode, getting them to go after a pitch they can't do much with becomes a lot easier.
Into the box, Kyle Schwarber. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. Comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ball game. Here's the 1-1 delivery. Outside, 2-1.
Well, that's a good pitch, but you have to get a little bit closer to the plate than that. That's that big sweeping slider. If it was a little closer, you might get a swing.
The 2-1. This is hit the other way out toward left field. Garcia is in pursuit. He can't get to it. This one's down. Not in time, and he's in there with a double. Wilson Contreras, and he's got a chance to bring in the winning run. The question is whether they'll even pitch to him. First pitch of the at bat on its way. He'll start him here with a changeup, but it's taken for ball one. Down the third baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Garcia is after it. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out. So digging in now, Jason Hayward, as he'll look to get the ball into the outfield and bring home what would be the winning run from second base. He's set. Here it comes. Swing and a grounder fouled off to the left. Hayward, or often just Jay Hay. He was a first-round pick back in the draft of 2007.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on the superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go in the high rounds, and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
The 1-1. This is on the ground over to first. Abreu will take this one over to first, and with that, the inning ends. One hit, one left. On to the top of inning number five we go, and we are tied 0-0. Welcome back. Heidi Watney standing by as we get set for the top of the fifth.
Thanks, Matt. I had a chance to talk with White Sox manager Rick Renteria between innings about his thoughts on his lineup's performance. And he said they just aren't putting enough competitive at-bats together right now. He told me he can't recall many times where they've been able to get to a full count today. And while that's not always a necessity for success, they've clearly had their struggles today, especially when it comes to making things difficult on the opposing pitching.
Thank you, Heidi. Standing in, Wellington Castillo. Batter pitcher matchup numbers with Tyler Chatwood. He brings a 4-for-12 line. Here's the pitch. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. And it looks like the Cubs will get a left-hander up and working out of the bullpen. Now the 1-0. Misses, ball two. The 2-0 on the way. A swing and a miss. That's the first strike.
I think it's safe to say he wasn't ready for the fastball.
Yeah, and they set him up with that curveball on the pitch before, and that one, they just blew right by him.
And they could go either way now, I suppose.
All even now, 2-2. The 2-2. Fouled away. Here now the 2-2. Hit hard towards second. And the White Sox have their first hit of the game. So that'll go down as an E4, as he certainly had his problems that time at second base. Standing in, Leury Garcia. Go-ahead run at first. Nobody out. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. A fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0.
Yeah, that looked like a strike, but let me tell you, when you're staring at a big zero in the hit column, getting a call like that to go your way can feel like a big victory.
And this one's down the middle, a ball and a strike.
I know to the fans that probably looked like something good to hit, but unless you're sitting breaking ball right there, I don't care if it's middle of the plate, that's a tough pitch to pull the trigger on.
The 1-1. There's a swing and a high deep drive headed for the right field corner. And nearly into the hit column in a big way. Instead, it's a foul ball. He's set and the 1-2 pitch. Swing and a little blooper to center. Coming in is Almora. This one's down. It's the White Sox first hit, and it's going to be for extra bases. Throw will hold him at second, but the go-ahead runs in scoring position now with still nobody out. Now at the plate, Tim Anderson. He's 0-for-1 thus far. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Cut fastball taken for strike one.
You're on the mound in this situation. You only have two options. You got to find a way to strike this next guy out or get him to ground into a double play.
A ball and a strike. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Waiting on it is Almora. One out. A look at our line score here through the first four, and as we've mentioned, just one hit for these guys this afternoon. So two men are on with one man out. And moving into the batter's box next will be Yomer Sanchez. From the stretch, here's the pitch. He'll start him with a breaking ball. Too low that time. It's ball one. Casilla on second. Garcia at first. One gone. That misses 2-0.
Well, I know the last thing he wants to do is load the bases right here, so the pressure is on right now to get back in the strike zone.
Now the 2-0 is swung on and missed, strike one. Now the 2-1 pitch. Taken, strike two. No runs, just one hit, and no errors so far for the White Sox. And that misses, so it's a full count, 3-2.
I don't think he can afford another base runner here, so whatever pitch he feels best about, whichever one he feels most comfortable with, that's the one I expect him to turn to.
Count remains full. The 3-2 one more time. And this one misses here. A close pitch on 3-2, but Clyde Washington rules it ball four.
I think he was trying to be a little too fine there, and a walk is the result. Well, the good news is he has a force at every base. The bad news, a single probably drives in a couple of runs.
Stepping into the box, Adam Engel. So far, 0-for-1 with a flyout.
Yeah, give me the same at bat. As you stride to the plate right here, give me the same execution. Just get something in the air. You got a chance to take the lead right here. Don't try and do any more.
The way this guy at the plate gets down the line, contact is your friend in this situation. Tough to double him up. This middle infield has got to do their best to roll it as quick as possible.
Fastball that time is nowhere close, and it's even at 1-1.
Amazing he was able to lay off in this situation. Your eyes light up when you get something above the belt, especially with a man on third base.
He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Weak grounder down the line at third. A tag for one, but he'll put this in his pocket and be content with just the one out. So digging in now, Carlos Rodon, as he'll hit with the go-ahead run at third and two away. From the stretch. In there, no balls and a strike.
Getting that first pitch strike is really important when you're dealing with the bases loaded behind you. Good job to give himself the advantage there.
Gets the fastball by him here, and he's in control, 0-2.
Hey, I know it's the pitcher at the plate, but he's going to grind it out right here. He's got a chance to help himself, and nothing's a bigger backbreaker to a team than watching the pitcher drive in a run.
And he strikes him out. So a missed opportunity at the plate as he strands three runners, and the side is retired. White Sox will strand three. Halfway home, still no score. Welcome back for the bottom of the fifth. Here's Heidi Wachnig.
Thanks, Matt. Between innings, I was able to discuss the current state of the Cubs lineup with manager Joe Maddon, and he told me he's pretty unhappy with their discipline at the plate in this one. A lot of their outs have come from weak contact and strikeouts as a result of chasing pitches outside the strike zone. He said it's going to be extremely important for them going forward to be more selective with their swings and force the opposition to throw more strikes.
Thank you, Heidi. At the plate, Albert Almora, as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. First delivery to him on the way. Just off the outside, and it's 1-0. A two-ball, no-strike count to the Cubs center fielder. Almora sees the ball really well when facing left-handed pitching and generally picks up a lot of hits against southpaws. He isn't known for displaying a ton of power, however, in these matchups.
Yeah, in today's game, when you're hearing the word launch angle, I don't think it applies to him against left-handed pitching. He can put a lot of balls in contact. He doesn't get himself into too many count leverage situations and tries to go deep too much. Just a guy who really puts bat to ball.
Three balls and a strike to the Chicago leadoff hitter.
You can bet they'd love ball four here. That gives the pitcher on deck an obvious bunt situation to move the runner into scoring position.
The 3-1 pitch. Ripped down the line, but a foul ball, and it's full now at 3-2. right down Main Street caught him looking.
This guy is really locked in on the bump right now. He's just playing good old-fashioned hardball right now, just rearing back and letting it go. And it seems like this lineup, they don't have an answer for anything he's bringing so far.
Ian Happ will move into the on-deck circle now to try to get something started here with one gone in the inning. First pitch fastball in there for a called strike. And now a pitch on the way. A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
I gotta say, his command of the corners in this start has been pretty exceptional. He's mixed east and west really well, and it's a big reason why he's had success.
Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. No runs, four hits, one error for the Cubs to this point. Unable to find the zone with the slider. And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2. And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
Wow, from 0-2 to 3-2, and that last pitch on 2-2 wasn't even close. He had this guy in the ropes, but now he let him right back into this at bat.
And a fastball swung on and missed as he just reared back there, two away. So the batting order turns over now and set to go Ben Zobrist. He's 1-for-2 in the ballgame. First offering on its way. Drops in a strike to start the at bat. Nothing and one. The 0-1 pitch. Now that's popped up. Abreu is there, and the side is retired. Three up, three down for the Cubs. Sixth inning coming up, still zip, zip. Mike Montgomery takes over to start the sixth inning on the mound. Back to the top of the White Sox lineup now, and stepping in, Brandon Guyer. His head-to-head history with Montgomery. He's hitless in three at-bats. Here comes the first pitch. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Montgomery features one of the biggest yakkers in the game. Curveball's got a ton of movement. And low, it's a ball and a strike.
Tried to go with the nasty backdoor breaking ball right there. Good job by the batter to take that pitch, work the count even.
Missed with the curveball there, and he falls behind a 2-1. Couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen. Now the 2-1. Takes a pass and misses. That's strike two.
Oh, man, he took a swing and a half at that one. I think some frustration is creeping into these guys, so he might have just been trying to get his guys on the board with one swing.
And it's fouled away. 2-2 one more time. He did well to get a piece that time, and it'll stay 2-2. Ready with another 2-2. And a foul pop behind the plate. Contreras is under it, and he hauls it in for the first out of the inning. Stepping up to the plate, Yoan Moncada. He was a ground out victim last time up. First pitch of the at bat on its way. Here's Zobrist now at second. Throw in time at first for out number two. Into the box now, Jose Abreu. No hits in two trips to the plate for him in the ballgame. First pitch coming, here it is. Good pitch there down below the zone, got him to go after it.
This offense has just been flailing at the plate all game long, so it's no wonder why they've only been able to pick up one hit so far. I'm not seeing much of a game plan from these hitters.
Into the wind, the 0-1. Behind 0-2 now.
If I'm on the mound right now, I know I'm in the hitter's head. He was definitely sitting soft. I might speed him up and elevate it right here.
And he won't offer it that. Too high. 1-2.
You know, Matty, I'm not surprised by that pitch. Raise the eye level a little bit. Maybe we get something bouncing in the dirt right here.
Bases are empty here with two men out. Grounder down the line at third, but this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Now a fastball awfully close, but he doesn't get the call. It's 2-2 now.
This kind of hitter right here, we call this guy a grinder. What are grinders? They just kind of foul off some good pitches. They lay off the pitches just off the...
Swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. 1-2-3 go the White Sox. And this is still a nothing-nothing ballgame. Ready now, Chris Bryant, 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far.
This guy has been unbelievable. There were billboards outside Wrigley while he was still in AAA, and what does he do when he shows up? Rookie of the year, MVP. I mean, get in line.
Now here's the pitch. Drilled on the ground to short. Throw in time as he's called out on a bang bang play at first. Now at the plate, Anthony Rizzo, 1-for-2 with a double on the ledger so far. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. And he'll power in a fastball that time at 94 for strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Hit down the third baseline, but that'll get foul. It's 0-2 now. Bases are empty, one man out. Pulled the fastball down a little too much there. That's ball one. To hold back, but he won't be able to, as that's ruled a swing, and there are two away now.
Always tough for one of these base umpires to make a call on a guy's check swing. It's not a great angle, and everything happens so quickly, so they really have to be paying attention out there. Looking at the replay, I think he got it right, so that's a tip of the cap for the Blue.
Digging in now, Javier Baez. And Dan, it seems like this starter is just dominating the game right now. Feels like we're seeing a lot of three up, three down innings.
No doubt about that, Matt. Hey, I've enjoyed watching him go about his business, but I'm also interested to see if this offense can figure out a way to get a couple of cracks in his armor before it gets too late.
Yeah, that remains to be seen. First offering on its way. Below the knees, one ball, no strikes.
Wow, count now 1-0 with a real good slugger up at the plate. This is the time as a pitcher you have to really make some good pitches. This is not the time to just groove one right down the middle.
Good slider there, but laid off and called the ball low.
Not the ideal spot to be right here. 2-0 count on a real good hitter. Boy, you're going to have to make some really good pitches now.
Too tight with that one. 3-0.
I wouldn't be surprised if he had the green light here. Matter of fact, I know he's got the green light here. He's looking for something set or cut, and he's looking to do damage.
Cubs shortstop with a 3-1 count.
Gotta believe he had the green light in that situation. Two outs, 3-0 count. This guy can certainly handle the bat. That's a perfect situation to let him loose. But I love the fact that he's key-holding a certain area, and it wasn't what he was looking for.
Hit in the air down the right field line. Guyer is under it, and he makes the catch for out number three. Cubs are down in order. We are still scoreless. Welcome back here to the historic friendly confines of Wrigley Field. Neither team denting the run column quite yet as we look at the game summary through the first six innings of play. Now at the plate, Wellington Castillo. His head-to-head history with Montgomery, he's gone 2-for-5. Here's the first pitch to him. That one's down around the knees, taken for a strike. One and one, the count to Wellington Castillo. The 1-1 home. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Nasty breaking ball swung on in the dirt. And the throw is there to record the first out. Into the box, Leury Garcia. Last time through was a base hit.
Yeah, guys, still the only hit in this game so far. They've been pretty well shut down. Guys on the mound have really much controlled the whole outcome up until this point.
Lifted down the line and left. But this will land untouched. One out, nobody on. Here's a fastball that crowds him a bit, and it's 1-1. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. Oh, and not an easy pitch to lay off of, but he did somehow, and he's got it to 3-1.
Walks are never good, but they're especially bad news late in games like this. It seems like they always come back to bite you.
And the 3-1. This one's blooped out toward right center field. Hayward coming on. He gets there and makes a fine running play for the second out. So two away here is the Sox bat in the seventh. And up next, it'll be Tim Anderson. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And he lays off there 1-0. inside, and he falls behind the hitter now, 2-0. Outside, 3-0 now.
Yeah, he's all over the place right now. No doubt, he's clearly fighting his mechanics.
Two out, nobody on. Into his motion, and the 3-1. 3-1 is a fastball, and he can't connect. 3-2.
The way he's been able to command his fastball those first two pitches, don't be shocked if he goes back in there again or goes up under his chin or nasty slider down and away. He has opened up his full arsenal.
Into the windup, the payoff pitch. A shot down the first baseline, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again. 3-2. Good battle here. This will be the seventh pitch coming up. And he lays off ball four. Now the potential go-ahead run is on base here. Striding in, Yomer Sanchez. There are two gone and the possible go-ahead run at first. Before the delivery, a check on that go-ahead run at first. And a dive, but he's back in there. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. First offering to him stays upstairs. It's a ball and no strikes. Two out with the possible go-ahead run at first. Anderson's running. Pitch inside, the throw. And he'll be tagged out at second base. Trying to get into scoring position, but instead the inning is over. Another look at the throwdown that results in a third out on the bases. Back with more from Wrigleyville right after this. Now at the plate, Kyle Schwarber. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Well, he got a good pitch to hit last time up. Looked for it up in the zone and didn't miss it. Those are the pitches you only get maybe once an AB, maybe once a game, maybe once a week. So he certainly capitalized on it last time.
And that's taken for strike one.
We're moving along into the later innings, and this guy's throwing over 60% of his first pitches for strikes. He'd like to do a little bit more, but so far, so good.
1-1 to Schwarber.
These guys have got to be frustrated as an offensive unit so far in this one. They haven't been able to crack the code on their opponent, but it's not like they're getting great pitches to hit either. This starter has kept the ball on the corners of the zone all game long.
Here's the 1-1 pitch. 2-1. To 2-2 now. Here's a swing and a long drive high in the air and deep to center field. Ball game. So it's a solo shot to dead center, and none bigger than that one as this ball game is over.
Well, the way things unfolded, you kind of had a sense that this thing was going to end in dramatic fashion, and that's exactly what happened. A walk-off for the win? Wow.
It was mostly pitching and defense in this one, but the man you see here made some noise with the bat, and as a result, he's our top player of the game.
When you walk up to the plate and hit a walk-off tater, you're probably going to be the player of the game, and that was a clutch swing of the bat, and he'll be riding high on that one for a while, I'm sure.
A single run good enough to do it today. 1-0 the final score. Chicago jumped ahead in the seventh inning and never gave the lead back. Mike Montgomery takes home the win. Carlos Rodon is settled with a loss after giving up only one earned. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian.